Great stories often start from small and humble beginnings. Since its inception in 1931, the Cambridge School has grown to become one of the strongest long-standing institutions in Delhi and NCR. Spread across five campuses, each of them becoming an educational lighthouse for thousands of students who have successfully emerged from within its portals.
My father's name was Alok Chandra Deb. He had this urge to help children learn. So he started a school in Dehradun in a house called Tipara House. And from Tipara House, he moved to Delhi, Jhandewala. And that is where the story of Cambridge School starts. He had one room, which was the school in the daytime, and also his bedroom at night. From there, he moved to 21 Daryaganj. From 21 Daryaganj to number 2 Daryaganj. That was called Peace Cottage in our time. The name Cambridge School came because he was the first person to send children up to Allahabad for the senior Cambridge examination. There was no other board at that time. People talk about activity-based learning, but my father had it from 1931. He was very keen that education should be complete.
Activities during the early days of Cambridge School were varied and included boxing, horse riding, carpentry, handicrafts, performing in the school band, and doing PT drills. From an early age, children were taught gardening, how to feed animals and birds, and milk the buffaloes.
I've been fortunate to be associated with Dr. Kalyani Roy, who's inherited the legacy from her father and whose vision she is taking forward. You'll find very few trusts or societies run by academicians or intellectuals or thinking people and whose entire focus is on education. They have no other interest except education.
The foundation stone of the building was laid by Dr. Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, and the school was designed by Mr. Jabwala. By the time it was made, it was a beautiful structure. And so my father invited Mrs. Indira Gandhi to inaugurate the building, and she readily agreed to come.
In Noida in 1981, there were scarcely any schools. The parents wanted to send their children to school, they were aspirational, but the opportunities weren't there. So when Cambridge School opened there, there was a great demand for that school because the reputation had already been built up at Srinivaspuri, at Daryaganj. That here was a school which was giving quality education along with ethical values to their children at an affordable rate. Of course, there was magic in the air. The teachers were all enthused because we were growing at so many different levels. New schools were coming up. That school itself was growing. So it was a magical time for all of us. We were all learning new things. We were all doing new things. We were all collectively building up these Cambridge schools. And there seemed to be a spurt of growth for the society. The Cambridge Primary School at New Friends Colony saw a total transformation. It's now become a very modern, a very aesthetically appealing school and greatly in demand in that area of New Friends Colony.
Schools are generally happy places to work in, especially primary schools where there are such small children. They come in very enthusiastic, full of joy and curiosity. It's infectious. It's always nice to come to school and I feel excited because it's such a nice place to work. I think if we take the lead from their curiosity and work our curriculum around it, that really helps. I mean, we can't do it entirely, but start from what they are interested in and then take it to where you want it to go. When a child joins school, he's feeling a little uncomfortable. It's a new place. So we make sure that there is a special buddy who will look after the child, introduce him to all the didi bhaiyas around, show him all the places, him or her. Generally make the child feel comfortable, and I think it really helps if there is a special buddy.
If you have compassion and feeling for your fellow human and for other forms of life as well, you will have sympathy for people in their different circumstances and understanding of other points of view. And that is what will make you a tolerant and a balanced individual. And I think this is what Cambridge School stands for. In Cambridge School, we are moving more and more towards learning by doing. This is something that all of us talk about. It's quite challenging to do, but it's also very exciting. And we find that children who actually learn by doing, they learn something very thoroughly, and they are able to apply skills from different disciplines and different subjects into actually doing something, creating something. And that kind of learning is invaluable. It brings into play the sort of skills they are going to need later on in life.
I'm Umesh Mathur. I did my senior Cambridge from the Cambridge School when it was in Tudariaganj, and that was in 1956-57, and I have really great memories. I'm grateful to such an institution that it has shaped me, not only me, many other students like me who have done silently a lot of contribution to building of the nation. This was the dream of Principal Day.
I have a 10-year-old daughter called Roshni who suffers from autism spectrum disorder. There is no day that I don't thank the universe for giving me and my daughter the opportunity to be a part of Cambridge Primary School. I won't say that Roshni took to the school or the environment immediately, but all the right elements were absolutely in place. There was complete acceptance, there was complete support as far as flexibility and customization of curriculum was concerned. And the biggest thing is that the school had the courage and the compassion to let the parents come into the classroom and assist their child. The expectation of the school is that the child will learn certain skills in the classroom, and then those skills will stay for life with the child and help the child in inclusion in the society as well.
It's been 20 years when I passed from Cambridge School to Srinivaspuri, but I still feel that the warmth and the emotion which I got during my education here has been completely overwhelming.
Cambridge was not a school, it was a family for me. I entered the school when I was 5 years old and I stayed here for around 12, 13 years.
It's a wonderful experience to have my child study in the same school from where I have passed out.
They were all evolving academically, there were new subjects being introduced, there were subjects like legal studies, there were subjects like fashion designing, aesthetically appealing subjects like theatre and education. Steps were being taken to change the way that children were being taught, almost like moving from the blackboard to the digital board.
Children have opportunities to be immersed in nature, to enjoy the outdoors, which I think previous generations had, and this generation brought up in cities and in high-rise apartments finds difficult.
We lay special emphasis not just on the teaching of drawing, but we make sure that children appreciate art, because everybody cannot become an artist, but everybody can have aesthetic sense and appreciate things which are beautiful and contribute to a more beautiful world that way.
My name is Carolina Prada. I come from Colombia in South America. I'm a Mayurbanj Chau dancer and an Odissi dancer. Having dance and performing arts as part of the curriculum here at Cambridge School is a really wonderful opportunity for children to grow up have a more enriching learning process because learning dance, martial arts, Indian classical dances, they give such a wonderful opportunity to build your character, to develop yourself, to grow as a person, and just to complement all the learning process.
Cambridge School NCC cadets!
We have had a lot of emphasis on sports, particularly sports for girls. Very deliberately got them into it. There are mixed teams. Girls and boys play together as one class team. When they go out of the school, there is a girls' football team, a girls' cricket team. That has helped to make girls feel that we can do it.
Going forward, I think we are going to be involving people outside the school community in the learning in the classroom, but also outside the classroom. We are going to be using them increasingly to develop a culture of excellence. I think this is going to help us at Cambridge to be ready for the future.
Cambridge boys are known to me very good professionals, very meaningful, very sincere, very dedicated, very devoted, and are not publicity conscious. That is more important for a professional.
The feeling of complete love and acceptance that the school has been able to inculcate in all its students and all its staff.
The values on which I have built my career, the same values I can see my child imbibing from school, which gives me a lot of confidence that he will do whatever he wants to achieve in life.
And not only that, a person who is dedicated towards humanity. So I thank Cambridge with all my heart and wish it all the best.
They may be unsung heroes in the country, but they are heroes in their own right.
This is something which is very rare, to be never made to feel smaller because your child is different.
It is our endeavor at the Cambridge Schools to produce students who will go on to be worthy citizens of our country, who will be egalitarian, secular, free-thinking, caring for others, and who will always try and put service before self.
We learn to value service. Every child learns to value service in our schools and to help those that need help. We don't talk about it. We don't talk about service or helping anybody. We just do it. We just do it. We learn to serve.
We learn to serve. We learn to serve.
We learn to serve.
Cambridge School looks forward to serving the nation and playing its part in grooming India's future generations with pride, confidence, and total integrity.